Hey, Ruan here from TunnelvizionTV, and welcome back to the Premiere Pro video series. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to create basic keyframes. Also keyframes on your video and also keyframes on your audio. So let's start with video. I'm going to drag in clip one into my sequence, and you can add keyframes basically to any parameter that you can change. So with this clip selected, clip one selected, I'm going to go into my effect controls here at the top. And then you'll see all these little stopwatches next to most of these, or almost all of these parameters. And that means that you can add a keyframe to that parameter. So let me show you. Let's say we want to scale this video and we want to scale it over time. I'm going to go to the area where I want to start the transition or the actual animation. And I'm going to click the stopwatch next to scale. And it will basically create a keyframe for scale 100, and let's move the play a little bit further, and then we're going to change the scale to 200, and then it's going to automatically create a second keyframe. Here you can see there's a keyframe there and there's a keyframe there. Now if I play this back, you'll see that the video will increase from 100 to 200. If I scrub through this, you can see, if you look at this number here by scale, you'll see that it's going to go up from 100 to 200 over time. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to delete these keyframes. So you can just highlight them here and press delete, and it will basically just go back to 100. So we can also add keyframes to things like rotation. So I'm just going to click on the stopwatch next to scale because we don't want to animate that anymore, or we don't want to add any more keyframes to that. So let's go to rotation, and right at the beginning I'm going to set a keyframe on rotation on 0. And then I'm going to go slightly further and I'm going to change this to, let's do it like 90 degree angle. And now if I go back to the beginning and I play this back, you'll see that it's going to increase from 0 to 90 over time. You can also see there's the two keyframes. So the first keyframe is right at the beginning and the second keyframe is right about there. And you can also go ahead and you can click and drag these keyframes to change the duration basically between, or the time between those two keyframes. So now if I play this back, you'll see that that animation will be a lot slower because we increase the distance between those two keyframes. Alright, so I'm going to delete these two keyframes, and I'm also going to click on the stopwatch next to rotation to switch that off, just to have it back to normal. So now I'm going to show you how to add some audio level keyframes. So now if I just expand this audio layer, just so that we can see a little bit more that's going on, so we can just get a better view of this audio channel or this audio layer. So now I can go ahead and I can add a keyframe on the audio level 0. And another way to add a keyframe is to click on this little dot here. It's going to add a keyframe. And then I'm going to go slightly further and I'm going to set the volume to, let's say, 5 decibels. And you'll see that it's actually going to create a keyframe here in our sequence. So now you can see it's going to go from 0. And if I scrub through this, and if you look at this number next to the audio level, you can see that it's going to go from 0 up to 5. Now we can create another audio level somewhere around here. I'm going to go back to 0. So I'm just going to type in 0 there, and it's going to create another keyframe right there. So now it's going to go from 0 to 5 and then back to 0. You can also go ahead and you can change these keyframes manually here. So you can just click and drag in the timeline or in your sequence to change the value and also the position of these keyframes. So this is really nice if you want to change the volume over time. You want to make it go louder or softer at a specific time in your video. You can just click these keyframes and adjust them like that. If you want to create a new keyframe in your sequence right here, you can hold in Command on your keyboard, and you'll see that your mouse pointer will change to white and it's got a little plus next to it. So now I can just click and I can create new keyframes, and if I release Command, I can now go and adjust these keyframes. Alright, so another thing that we can do, I'm going to bring in a photo. So I'm just going to bring in photo 2, and I'm going to place it over this video. So now if we play this back, you'll see it's basically just going to cut straight to that photo. And first of all, I want to scale it up so it's filling the area of the screen. So I'm going to click on the photo, and then under effect controls, I'm just going to scale it up so it is just filling that section of the screen. And now I want to basically fade in the opacity of this photo too. So we can easily do that by using keyframes on the opacity parameter. So I'm going to select my photo, and I'm going to go to the first frame of my photo. So I'm going to use the arrow keys on the keyboard to go to the first frame of that photo, and then under opacity on that photo, I'm going to change the opacity to 0. As you can see, it's completely transparent now, and I'm going to go slightly forward with a playhead, and then I'm going to change the opacity to 100. So now if we play this back from here, you'll see that the opacity will increase on the photo from 0 to 100. And that's basically a transition that we just created, but we created it manually by using keyframes under the effect controls. So that's how easy it is to use keyframes inside of Premiere Pro. I'll see you guys in the next video.